Welcome back to this calculus problem of the day. Here we're given a function f of x equals x squared plus 49, and we're asked to evaluate this messy looking function down here. Now in just a few short days, we're gonna be talking about difference quotients and average rate of change. So this function here is actually a glimpse into your near future. Let's try to evaluate it. So if f of x equals x squared plus 49, then we find f of 7 just by replacing x with 7. Squaring that 7 gives us 49 plus 49, so f of 7 equals 98. Okay, we're going to use this in just a second. Let's find f of 7 plus h. Now what this notation means is we're going to take the x in our function and we're going to replace this x with a 7 plus h. That's going to look like this. So now instead of squaring x, we're squaring 7 plus h. In order to square 7 plus h, we need to do that whole foiling thing, which maybe is a little bit more clear if I write out this 7 plus h squared like this. Okay, multiplying our first two terms, our outer two terms, our inner two terms, and our last two terms. Don't forget the plus 49 at the end. And now we can reorder things a little bit and combine like terms. We get h squared plus 14h plus 98. And that is f of 7 plus h. And we're going to use this in just a second. Now let's look at this expression that we're supposed to simplify. Let's replace f of 7 plus h with our results. And let's replace f of 7 with the result we just got as well. Okay, great. We just copied down that expression with our two results. Now you'll notice that this 98 and this minus 98 cancel. That leaves us with an h squared plus 14h all over h. Now there's a couple ways to cancel this h from the denominator. One way to do it is to look at the numerator and realize we can factor an h out of the numerator. If we factor an h out of the numerator, we end up with h times the quantity h plus 14. Now this factor of h in the numerator can cancel with that factor of h in the denominator, and we are left with a final answer of h plus 14. That gives us the result that we're looking for in this problem. So that is our final answer. I hope that this helped you out, and I hope to see you again next time for tomorrow's calculus problem of the day.